Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, the ENT Resident. Today, I'll be discussing about a very important clinical examination of ENT, which is known as posterior rhinoscopy. Now, today, I'll be teaching you what is posterior rhinoscopy, what is the procedure to perform it, and what are the structures that you usually normally see in a patient, and what are the abnormalities to look out for. So, let's start with it. So posterior rhinoscopy, it is basically the visualization of the posterior nares or the cuana with the help of a mirror. Now the mirror that we use here is called a posterior rhinoscopy mirror. Now the size of the mirror can vary between 8 to 15 millimeter in diameter, but usually we are using a 10 millimeter mirror. Now coming to the procedure to perform posterior rhinoscopy. So first what you need to do is you have to make sure that a mirror is warmed so as to prevent condensation of vapor on it. Now there are many ways to do this. The most common one would be to dip the mirror in warm water, or you can also warm the mirror over the flame of a spirit lamp, or rub the mirror surface on buccal mucosa and generate heat by friction, or also you can actually use some defogging solutions like cetrimide. So once you are sure that the mirror has been warmed, you have to first test that warmth of the mirror on the flexor aspect of your wrist before you put it in the mouth. Now that your mirror is ready, first you spray the posterior pharyngeal wall of the patient with 10% lignocaine spray so as to prevent gag reflex of the patient, and give it 2 minutes to act. Now after that is done, you depress the tongue with the help of a tongue depressor with your left hand. Now that the tongue has been depressed and you can see the posterior pharyngeal wall properly, you introduce the mirror, you use the mirror in a pen-like fashion in your right hand. So you introduce the mirror, pass it behind the soft palate without touching the uvula and the surrounding structures so as to prevent gagging. And the patient is asked to breathe through the nose as you perform this so as to bring the soft palate forward. Now you can see in this picture, this is how you introduce the mirror, and this is the soft palate and the uvula. You pass it behind it, and here this is the mirror, and this is how you are able to visualize the structures in the nose and the nasopharynx. Now next we'll come to what are the structures that we see. The structures first that we see anteriorly, for the first structure basically to be identified would be the posterior end of the nasal septum. Now you see in this picture over here, this is the posterior end of the nasal septum. It will be a midline structure, and that is the first structure that you have to look out for. Now once you have seen the posterior end of the nasal septum, you have to note the posterior ends of the middle and inferior turbinates and the superior turbinate. Now the superior turbinate would be the highest landmark that you may or may not be able to see while doing a posterior rhinoscopy. Other than this, you may also see the posterior part of superior and middle meatus and the nasal surface of the soft palate and uvula if you tilt the mirror slightly anteriorly. Now after anteriorly, you go on to the lateral structures. Now laterally, you're going to be noticing the eustachian tube openings on either side with tubal elevations behind the posterior end of the inferior turbinate. And just behind the eustachian tube orifice, you will also see the fossa of Rosenmüller. This is slightly more difficult to examine. And superiorly, you'll be noting the roof of the nasopharynx. You'll find adenoids at the junction of the roof and the posterior wall of nasopharynx in case of children. And you'll also note the superior part of the posterior pharyngeal wall. So these are the structures that you normally see in while you are performing posterior rhinoscopy. Now if you look at this picture, this is how it is looking like. Midline you see the nasal septum. These are the two cuana on both the sides. This is the uvula and the soft palate. And you can see the superior, middle and the inferior turbinates. And laterally you see the eustachian tube orifice and the tubal elevation and the fossa of Rosenmüller behind it. Now this is an endoscopic picture of the nasopharynx. As you can see, this is the posterior end of the septum. This here is the eustachian tube orifice. Behind that, you will find the fossa of the Rosenmüller. So these are the structures that you are supposed to be seeing in a normal person. Now, in these cases, usually when we are performing, we are usually looking out for any abnormality. Now, what are the abnormalities that you look for while performing posterior rhinoscopy? These would be polyps, like an antroguanal polyp, cysts, any secretions, a foreign body, ulcers, tumors like juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma or a nasopharyngeal carcinoma. Now, these are all the things that you have to look out for while examining. Lastly, this is a very difficult procedure to perform. So what are the difficulties that you usually face while performing it? Firstly, it is very difficult to perform in children and mentally retarded patients because they are not very cooperative while doing this procedure. Secondly, because of the gag reflex. Now, to take care of the gag reflex, as I already said earlier, you can use the 10% lignocaine spray before you perform the procedure. And thirdly, there will be recurrent fogging of the mirror. The first thing that I already told you is the ways to defog the mirror. So these are the ways you can take care of these difficulties as much as possible. So this is all about posterior rhinoscopy. I'll be catching you in my next video.